Welcome to Gridball 58, with me Joanne Keyes in Europe.
And I'm Dorothy D, covering the rest of the globe. And first, the big news from last weekend's Nations Cup, where both England and Wales were humiliated by amateur opponents. The Nations champions traveled to Honduras and were beaten by the only goal of the game, while the Welsh were in Uruguay and lost by the odd goal in three. The US will now be favorites to lift the crown after Barbara Jameson of Manchester and Peggy Rodman of Indianapolis scored in Northern Ireland, while Rotterdam's Joke Kreefkor scored a hat trick for Holland in Portugal. The Dutch will now host the Honduran Minnows on September 27, while the US hosts the French, and either Puerto Rico or Uruguay will be an unlikely semi-finalist after a dream draw for them. Moving on to today's club games, and Atlanta make one change from the team mauled by Willesden a fortnight ago, with goalie Sheila Vetter dropped in favor of Betty Leverett, while a goal for Joanne Suter will see her break her club's scoring season record of 12 she set last season. Cork also started with a disappointing home defeat to Los Angeles, however they welcomed back shooter Margaret Bauer for Nuala O'Brien, while goalie Patricia Allen didn't travel to the States with Kim Lamont coming in.
Willesden have kicked into gear and produced three ominous bonus point wins in their last three games, and include Margaret Rees and Jean Anstice from the Welsh side humiliated in Uruguay last weekend. Los Angeles haven't conceded a goal in their last two road trips and are boosted by not having had any players away on international duty. It will be a great result if they avoid defeat here. Inter Group B and Monmouthshire will be confident of taking their unbeaten run to 10 games when they face the Mississippi Mockingbirds. The Beacons welcome back three players who were away on international duty with Jill Jenkins and Christine Windham in that Welsh debacle, while Florence Murray was in Northern Ireland's defeat to the States. The Mockingbirds make two changes from the side that suffered a club record defeat in their last game against Plymouth. Frances Price returns in goal for Sheila Smith, and Diane Stevens comes back at left guard for Mary Wills. The Plymouth Pilgrims are in great form going into their game with Dublin, and have Irma Blue back from international duty for the USA last week. Dublin have now suffered back-to-back 7-goal defeats. Not surprisingly, Julia Hilditch rings the changes, with Jay Bart, Jacqueline Lynch, and June Dyson all back in the side in place of Finula McGilligan, Jane Driscoll, and Audrey Flanagan. The Glasgow Claymores batted off their Group C campaign by scoring a sixth win on the run in Portsmouth a fortnight ago, and now host their most recent victims in the rematch with an unchanged side that includes Fraser, Yuri Law and Logan, who were all on Scotland duty in last weekend's win over Finland. Portsmouth's first-choice shooter Inga Carroll isn't risked, as she recovers from injury, so the youngster Kim Council continues as their spearhead.
St. Louis hosts the return match with Houston, trying to put that 9-1 club record mauling in Texas a fortnight ago behind them. The spirits are unchanged as Diane Callan returned from international duty with the States, having kept a clean sheet in Northern Ireland. Houston do have issues after right guard Margaret Rogers and sweeper Margaret Brent were both injured in a road traffic accident on the way to training last week. Irma Redding comes in for her fourth game this term, while attacker Georgina Borman will come in as a makeshift sweeper for what looks like a much closer tie than the scoreline a fortnight ago suggests.
It's been a fortnight to forget for many of the Liverpool Liverbirds, who were on the wrong end of a shock defeat in Lanarkshire a fortnight ago, and then followed that with Kay Kehoe Sim and Jellicoe all in the England side humiliated in Honduras last weekend. Catherine Malloy was spared the pain of both games as she recovered from injury, and will be much welcomed back in place of Gloria Jameson, but Janet Horsburgh is sacrificed in place of April Henschel in goal. Cheshire's Carol Watson was also on that painful flight back from Central America this week with her three England colleagues that she faces today. The Cats have won 5 on the spin, but will need to be at their best to get something today. Manchester's 12-game unbeaten run came to an end in Cheshire last time out, but they remain unchanged as they try to get back to winning ways. Barbara Jameson was their only player on international duty last week, but stayed in the UK as her USA team were in Northern Ireland. The Miners are on a high after a great win over Liverpool to start their second round campaign, while Magda Miller and Lois Crosby followed that with Scotland's win last week over Finland, so it's no surprise they remain unchanged.
Atlanta's great season continues to impress with another great result against Cork. Margaret Bauer gave the Rebels an early lead, but an equalizer out of nothing for Kate Nation took them in level at the break before the Firecrackers put in a great Sandra Ivy-inspired second-half display. Joanne Suter gave them a third-quarter lead, breaking her own goals for a season record in the process before Virginia Woods sealed the win, and Suter was even able to afford to see her late dead hit saved by Kim Lamont.
Willesden's run of bonus points was brought to an end by a determined Los Angeles, for whom Diane Rowland secured a tie 10 minutes from the end of a game of few chances, where Rosalie Williams had given the Saxons a first-half lead. Mississippi showed glimpses of the team that shocked so many last season when Jean Allen put them in front in Wales, but the Beacons hit back quickly through Mary Gilbert before edging out a tight second half with Florence Heller's goal 9 minutes from the end. And Mississippi's miserable day was compounded with Sheila Everett expected to miss the next two games after picking up an injury. Sandra Garwood was the standout performer in Plymouth's victory over Dublin. The 16-year-old couldn't be blamed for Jade Bart's early goal for the Ravens, but the Irish never got a sniff of the Plymouth goal after that, which allowed Jill Marks and Nora Bartholomew to turn the game around before the interval. Marks put the game beyond Dublin's reach 10 minutes from time. It's been the day for comebacks as three of the four teams that went behind in groups A and B came back to win while the other was held to a tie, and that pattern has continued in group C, where Glasgow went behind early on to Kim Council's goal for Portsmouth, but the Claymores deservedly turned it around through Lydia Law's free hit before Eileen Logan struck twice in a few minutes to put the Scots in command.
St. Louis are the first team today to hang on to their lead after opening the scoring, and Maggie Cresswell's late effort capped a frustrating day for the Houston Stars' whole field. They should have had this game wrapped up long before losing it.
Liverpool-Cheshire clashes are always one of the biggest in Gridball, but the Liverbirds needed a response to that bad defeat to Lanarkshire last time out, and they got it in great style. Emma Kehoe-Sim dominated the court, and it was fitting she opened the scoring before Sabrina Kaye sliced the ball past her own goalie. Joan Lenore put a gloss on the result late on for a bad afternoon for the visitors. And finally Manchester got back to winning ways, ending Lanarkshire's three-game winning run in the process with a masterclass from their attacking partnership of Laurie Chernin and Lynn Cox, who dominated the Scottish defence and were awarded with a goal in each half for the shooter. We'll introduce you to the Bees in a moment, but first a look at the tables after Game 2, and Monmouthshire, Plymouth and Glasgow are the only teams with two wins, which demonstrates how tough the competition is at this stage, while it's two defeats for Cork, Mississippi, Dublin and Portsmouth, while Group 4 is anybody's guess with all four sides having won and lost a game.
In the race for the Golden Bat, Barbara Hoffman and Pamela Potter both failed to score today, allowing the veteran Rosalie Williams to close the gap, scoring the only Willesden goal against Los Angeles.